the opponent. The most exciting youngster in British boxing, Georgie Smith, achieved support status for the first time against the vastly experienced 30-year-old from Hanwell, Rudy Valentino. That is our chief support. Street, and we crack on now with one of the most exciting young prospects in the Matchroom stable, Georgie Smith, the light welterweight. No, not the young lady in the background. Georgie Smith against Rudy Valentino. And whereas Loriano Ramirez was a distinct step up in class for Michael Aldis, well, so Rudy Valentino, a big step up for young Georgie Smith, who I will guarantee you is commanding approximately 80% of the support here tonight. And we await the arrival of Rudy Valentino. So Rudy Valentino in the ring. Georgie Smith saga continues now. You never know if Rudy Valentino, who has proved he can do it early in his career, what a shortcut back to the top this would be. Round one, we're scheduled 8. I will be surprised if it goes that far.
Yes, he not only has power, Georgie Smith, but he has a great boxing skills. It's nice to see a young boxer who undoubtedly has power but prefers to box and work his way in, not just look for that one big single shot.
Yes, I've held fire, getting too carried away with Smith. I think he's really a very, very good prospect indeed. I think they would love him in America, and I'm sure Barry Hearn has got half an eye on the States as this youngster's career progresses. But he's going to be brought along very, very carefully and learn the game and learn it well. And it's all very well being flamboyant as long as you've got something to be flamboyant about. And I think he has. But how much could that can be developed? Well, that we shall have to see as the months and the years progress. He is obviously a very, very exciting prospect, and he can box a bit too. Perhaps we've got one criticism of him so far, perhaps. Maybe takes one or two shots more than he needs to, but all you've got to do is look at the features to see that he hasn't taken that many in his career so far.
Tends to be following Valentino around the ring, really, instead of just cutting him off, blocking him in that corner.
First time has been scheduled to go 8.
Good right hand over the top. Looking for that one a little bit too much, though.
Good opening from Smith. Nice start. The faithful enjoyed it.
Looks very young, doesn't he?
I think the description baby face was especially coined for him. Well, he doesn't fight like a baby. Look at this.
It was all Smith in the first round, and this is a good right hand over the top. That was there towards the end of the round. He's falling in slightly with that right hand, looking for it a bit too much. But he's only a novice yet in this game.
That's why we can't just clear up the scheduled distance of this fight. We were told it was 8-3s, but they've shortened it to 6-3s. So this is a 6 3-minute round light welter contest. And this is Rudy Valentino.
Round 2.
Second round. First round, Smith's. Valentino has been in with some good fighters, and he's generally around there or thereabouts at the finish. Doesn't get stopped that often.
Looked a bit open in the corner there, though. Smith was just winging past him with a few right hands and left hooks.
Yeah, any man really to do a number on him was Rashid Lawal. Stopped him, well, KO'd him in a round when they met in Denmark. But as I said, doesn't happen that often. Dig that from Valentino. That's what I mean about Smith perhaps on occasions taking shots that he needn't. I'm sure that'll be tightened up and improved as his pro career continues.
Yes, he shipped 2 good left jabs from Valentino. And maybe Valentino needs to go forward more. He's not done it until yet.
Well, Valentino, just the right sort of opponent for Smith to meet at this stage of his career. Good, experienced pro. And stress the experience. Packed an awful lot into these 31 fights prior to tonight's.
Seems to know what he's doing in the corner there, Valentino.
That's good stuff from Valentino.
Smith needs to be careful. Been caught with two good right hands and the jab again.
Good round, Valentino, this.
Confidence and putting some power into those shots.
Yeah, he's fighting well. See what he's been brought in to do. Stretch Smith, and he's doing just that. Good round. Valentino's round. Artillery that Smith took and left him unmarked, and here's some of it.
Yeah, this was the good right hands from Valentino. 1-2.
Third round. Valentino in the yellow with the blue cycle shorts underneath. Smith in the white and gold.
Do you know what, Dave? I love it when the cornermen tell their boys what to do and then say it's simple. And then they jump out of the ring and the bell goes and you're left there, just the two of you.
Listen, if you ever start training when your pro career's ended, you'll be saying that too.
That's right. I think what they mean, it's simple, their job. It's a dangerous left hook. And Valentino, as you say, has got good experience.
Well, it's all about careful matchmaking, which is where Frank Turner's art comes in. Got to stretch Smith just a little more each fight to make him think what little obstacles in front of him that must be overcome. It's absolutely pointless putting him in with fellas who's just going to roll over. That way he learns nothing.
Good right hand of the body from Smith.
And that might be the root of the body. Looks perhaps a little soft around the waist as Valentino. Quite a common amateur fall, just to go headhunting, ignore the body. Doesn't throw that many body shots. Smith makes me alarm by throwing one in right then. He could throw more.
Needs to be careful though. They're good punches from Valentino.
Yeah, Valentino, no mug, and he's still well in this fight. Smith continues to stalk him. Back to a corner. Valentino fights his way out.
good pressure display from Smith, who he's obviously got a lot of confidence in his fitness. Relentless, isn't it?
Good fighter. At the moment, the punch is tending to bounce off Valentino, but you wonder for how long. Well, I think that the pressure that Smith is putting Valentino under, were it an eight-round fight, as it originally had supposed to have been, I think that power might have told in the latter stages. As it is, he might have to settle for points second time in his career, because he hasn't hurt Valentino yet. Ken's got a bit wild, doesn't he, Nicky, when he's in close?
Yes, he does. It's relentless, and Valentino is still dangerous and coming back with good right hands like that. Smith actually got his glove in the way of that one, but he's being caught with counter punches.
Corners, 10 seconds. Seconds up, round four.
A lot of power for the fight now, round four, schedule six. Well, Smith went to points in his first fight against Malcolm Thomas. He's won all of them since then.
Seems to have calmed it down a bit this round. That pace was very hot, and he's probably been told just to take his time and use the jab. Nothing dangerous.
No, in a way, I think the best thing that happened to Smith was winning his pro debut, not by the short route, but by being on points. Takes a lot of pressure off. Rudy Valentino is still very much a live opponent.
It looks as though he is tiring slightly, Georgie Smith. Both of them, in fact. The heck of a pace for three rounds.
Good body shot. Decent jab. Can win it on the jab alone, Smith. That's better, that's good. And that has opened up Valentino quite well. Valentino comes back, clipping him with the right hand around the side of the head. Tries a jab of his own. But Smith's got the height and reach, and he can out jab Valentino all night long if needs be. He can be relentless, Smith, can't he?
Well, he certainly applies the pressure. That hairdo of his, though, although a bit fancy, I think actually exaggerates the effect of the opponent's punch. The punching it makes it look as though he's been really caught with a good punch when actually hardly hit at all.
I just wonder if that air can be comfortable, you know, when you're fighting.
Well, I don't know, but there you see the head fly back and the hair going everywhere, and that was a good shot. But even the slightest of punches really look effective when George Smith gets caught, because that hair flies about.
One, two. Right, don't run. One, two. 10 seconds.
That's cool for you. Have a little laugh with your trainer before going out.
Second up, round five.
Round five. Scheduled six, remember. Smith in the white and gold and the hair and the razzle dazzle. And Rudy Valentino, there you go. In yellow with the blue cycle shorts underneath. Steve Parris is the referee. Good stuff. Doubling up. This is good. Now watch this. Working for the opening. He's not going to let him out.
He's hitting gloves, unfortunately, though.
Powerful shots. Tactic of Rocky Marciano's, wasn't he? Just whack at anything. There's sometimes no bad tactic. You've got a man in the corner. Just whack him. Okay, they may not be point scoring punches, but they're effective punches. They hurt.
Well, yes, I mean, some blokes do actually aim for the bicep and try and get in the arm, slow the arms down. It's the reason that you keep whacking away, it's going to take some effect on those arms.
And he was really winding up with shots. Now, here he goes again. Valentino using all his experience, stay out of trouble, just to keep the guard up. No room for showboating. Looking pretty tired, Valentino, now hanging open.
Smith thinks about his shots, although he's actually catching the gloves of Valentino. He's looking for the openings, head and body, right arm, left arm.
Valentino just taking the mic a little bit. From Valentino. That's hurt Smith. That really has hurt him. Now then. Makes him miss. A little bit of showboating and Ali shuffle in return.
Well, he definitely hurt Smith with that right hand.
Definitely.
Needs to be careful, because he definitely was hurt there.
Absolutely. And good spirit between these two men. Crowd loving it. Not surprising. Good fight. He's some kid, this. And he's not bad either. Let's have a look at that punch again.
Yeah, this was it. He missed with his own punch, and Valentino got through that dangerous right hand. We felt the power of that punch right behind Valentino there. And there's no doubt that did wobble Georgie Smith.
Absolutely, and that's the one defect, and it is a serious defect, that needs to be tightened up. He takes more shots than he needs to. And for all the bravura, if he came up against a really heavy puncher, he wouldn't get away with what he did get away with in that last round against Valentino. Final round. And it's been another cracker. There never seemed to be anything but crackers when we have Georgie Smith on screen. Tremendous prospect. But there are lessons to be learned. Let's not get carried away.
Good body shots from Smith. He seems very vulnerable to that big right hand of Rudy Valentino's.
Well, I'm sure that Alex Gower is a wily old character. He'll watch reruns of this, he'll watch them with Georgie Smith, he'll point out what he's done well and what he has done not so well. All part of the learning curve, eh, Nicky?
Oh, it is, certainly. And when you've been hurt by a punch due to your lack of defense, then you learn quicker. Good right hand to the side from Georgie Smith.
Well, he takes the shot well, and he doesn't mark up, which is unusual in boxers with fair skin.
Well, I'm surprised at Valentino in this last round. He hasn't really pushed any advantage home that he had from the end of the fifth.
I'm not sure he's got the strength to do that.
Well, I think, as you say, he's probably a bit tired, and he's under immense pressure too.
Flying for one up the middle. The crowd signalling. Everybody knows it but Smith.
But he likes to put on a display, Georgie Smith, and he's done this tonight. The alley shuffle.
Yeah, an exciting kid, and I'm sure he'll do very, very well in this game as it goes on. And it seems that, well, they're both enjoying it. It's been fought in a cracking spirit. Dave Parris has hardly had a thing to do. Good fight. Lovely fight. And Georgie Smith knows he's got it. Dave Parris waits. Dave Parris hasn't had a chance to go near him yet. There it is. On points.
This contest, ladies and gentlemen, your appreciation for both boxers, Rudy Valentino and Georgie Smith. A great contest.
And a little round of applause for Rudy Valentino as well, because it takes two to make a good fight. And that's what he did. We'll get the points total now.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dave Parris scores the contest 57.5 to Rudy Valentino, 60 to Georgie Smith. It's 6-6 now. Georgie Smith is the winner.
Well, five rounds to Smith, one round even. That's about
ladies
right.
Ladies and gentlemen, your appreciation, please, for a very good loser.
As Alan Hughes said, Valentino. 6-6.
No doubt about the winner. He's your man. There he is, ladies and gentlemen, Georgie Smith. He's the winner.
So, let me quickly recap what we have seen tonight. We've seen Darren Westover knock out Nicky Wadman in one. We've seen Steve Roberts beat Robbie Darn on a third round stoppage. We've seen Georgie Smith just then outpoint Rudy Valentino. And we've seen Laureano Ramirez win the vacant WBO Intercontinental Super Bantamweight title with a majority points win over England's Michael Aldis. A decent evening's boxing. I guess that's just about it. Save to wish Nicky Piper well when his can't really call it a comeback, when he returns to the ring on Saturday. Good luck, Nicky. We'll see you
Thank
again
you.
Soon. We'll see all of you again soon. From Nicky, from me, David Brenner, we'll see you all very soon. But for now, from Basildon.